Transfer of heat. If heat energy is supplied to any substance, it will be transferred from one part of the substance to another part. It takes place in different ways depending on the state of the substance. Three ways of heat transfer are conduction, convection, and radiation. Let's see about conduction. Let's do an activity to know about conduction. Let's take hot water in a cup and put a silver spoon in it. Leave the spoon inside the water for some time. Now, touch the end of the spoon. Do you feel the heat? Yes. How did the other end of the spoon become hot? It is because heat in the hot water is transferred from one end to the other end of the spoon. In solid substances such as silver spoon, atoms are arranged very closely. Hot water molecules which are vibrating transfer the heat energy to the atoms in the spoon and make them vibrate. Those atoms make other atoms to vibrate and thus heat is transferred through the other end of the spoon. In conduction, heat transfer takes place between two ends of the same solid or through two solid substances that are at different temperatures but in contact with one another. Thus, we can define conduction as the process of heat transfer in solids from the region of higher temperature to the region of lower temperature without the actual movement of atoms or molecules. Let's see some examples of conduction in our daily life. We cook food in vessels made up of metals. When vessel is heated, heat is transferred from the metal to the food. When we iron dresses, heat is transferred from the iron to the cloth. Handles of cooking utensils are made up of plastic or wood because they are poor conductors of heat. The temperature inside the igloo, that is snow house, is warm because snow is a poor conductor of heat. Now, let's see about convection. Let's take some water in a vessel and heat it on a stove. Touch the surface of the water. It will be cold. Touch it after some time. It will be hot now. How did the heat which was supplied at the bottom reach the top? When water in the vessel is heated, water molecules at the bottom receive heat energy and move upward. Then molecules at the top come down and get heated. This kind of heat transfer is known as convection. This is how air in the atmosphere is also heated. Thus, the form of heat transfer from the places of higher temperature to the places of lower temperature by the actual movement of molecules is called convection. Convection takes place in liquids and gases. Now, let's see about convection in daily life. Formation of land breeze and sea breeze is due to the convection of air. Wind flows from one region to another region by convection. In hot air, balloons' heat is transferred by convection and so the balloons raises. In refrigerators, cool air moves downward and replaces the hot air because of convection. Now we shall see about radiation. Radiation is the third form of heat transfer. By conduction, heat is transferred through solids. By convection, heat is transferred through liquids and gases. But by radiation, heat can be transferred through empty space, even through vacuum. Heat energy from the sun reaches the earth by this form of heat transfer. Radiation is defined as the way of heat transfer from one place to another in the form of electromagnetic waves. Now, let's see about some examples of radiation in our daily life. Heat energy from the sun reaches the earth by radiation. While standing near fire, we feel the heat which is transferred as radiation. Black surfaces absorb heat radiation so that the bottom of the cooking vessels are painted black. White color reflects heat radiation. That's why we are advised to wear white clothes during summer.